Bhupendra, first I am reminded of the maxim, Mia Bibi Razi to kya karega Kazi.
Correct.
Nice. At the end of the day, Supreme Court is adjudicating a dispute. Now, if you look at the parties in the dispute, from the Muslim side, the sole claimant to the property is the Sunni Waqf Board. All other parties are not claimant to the property. See, Babri Masjid Action Committee, it is not a claimant to the property. In fact, All India Muslim Personal Law Board is not a claimant to the property. The only claimant to the property is the Sunni Waqf Board. Now, Sunni Waqf Board says, I do not want to claim the property. Then nobody can force Sunni Waqf Board to claim the property.
Sir, may I revert him?
So that's why I said, as far as the legal position is concerned, Mia Bibi Razi, kya karega Kazi?
Or more,
sir, before the judgment is pronounced, any day before the judgment, just a minute.
With due
any
respect.
Day before the judgment, anybody can go to the court and say,
of course. I heard a very
frivolous argument.
What?
I heard a very funny argument by Mr. Vijay Shankar saying Sunni Waqf Board is now represented by the lawyer. A lawyer is as good as the brief which has been given to him by his client. The client is at liberty to change his brief any time. The lawyer does not get any authority independent of the brief of the lawyer. Who has signed the wakalatnama? The Sunni Waqf Board president has signed the wakalatnama. The man who has given him the authority is the chairman. The chairman, if he withdraws the authority, he withdraws the authority.
Let's take it one by one. Because Sudhanshuji, if your argument is that the Waqf Board actually technically speaking cannot own the land, then I want to know what is the legal argument which is being made in the court. You are staking claim to the title soon.
According to Waqf Board, you cannot sell out the land.
Because if what you are saying is true, then Ajay Gautam and Sudhanshu will be jumping quickly. Because then that means that you are not agreeing with your own petition.
That's a very interesting point. Let me tell you further.
Sudhanshuji. Yes, go ahead. Go ahead, Sudhanshuji.
Very interesting point. You know, Maulana Sahib is here. I am so amazed that everybody wants to create a false impression that the Allahabad High Court judgment gave 1/3 of the property to the Sunni Waqf Board. Maulana is here. Ask him if it is not untrue. The Sunni Waqf Board did not get 1/3 of the land in dispute by the Allahabad High Court judgment. The Allahabad High Court judgment gave it to the Muslim parties. Now this was very interesting. Because why did it not give it to the Muslim to the Sunni Waqf Board? Because in its own judgment, it quoted the Supreme Court judgment of Ghulam Abbas versus State of UP 1984 Supreme Court, in which Supreme Court has already held that Sunni Waqf Board is not entitled to any claims over the Ram Janambhoomi land because the notification by which it claimed authority was struck down by the Supreme Court in 1984 itself.
Okay.
It is for this reason that Allahabad High Court did not give this land to Sunni Waqf Board.
Okay.
It gave it to the Muslim party.
Sunni Waqf Board is part of the Muslim
funny.
Party.
A land can only belong to an individual or an organization.
I got your point, Mr. Mittal. I think the problem is, and that's why I wanted to put this point on the table, that we are talking about an out-of-court settlement on an issue where there can never be unanimity between two sides. So maybe if the Sunni Waqf Board chairman has gone to the extent of submitting some report where maybe, as reporters are pointing out, if he's withdrawing his petition, that move will never be acceptable to the likes of Mr. Kasmi and many other Muslim individuals, because much like on the Hindu side where there is a dispute in terms of who really owns the land, on the Muslim side also there is a dispute. Correct. In terms of which body, which board technically speaking ends up owning the land. On the other,
Bipinda, any move which the Muslim parties are showing by way of gesture of relinquishing their claim is always welcome.
Mm. Yes.
There is no issue on that.
Mm.
Because from day one, it has been a stand that given the equity in the case and sensitiveness of the Hindu community,
mm.
goodwill should have been exhibited by Muslim communities because the two are not comparable.
Mm.
A mosque in comparison to the Janambhoomi of Lord Ram
mm.
are not comparable.
Okay.
So it was always expected
mm.
that the Muslim community will come forward to undo a historical wrong against the Hindu sentiment.
Okay.
Now if at a later stage also some people want to do that, they are most welcome. Any kind of move by the people.
Okay, let's take
so
a
any
break.
Kind of movement by the
let me take a break.
That of,
let me just take a break.
Sunni Waqf
Board is I just think certainly if this move has been made by the Sunni Waqf Board chairman, if at all this move has been made, as dramatic as it may sound, but well, if it's a move, then that move needs to be welcome, because if at the end of the day, on the 17th of November, when the judgment comes in favor of any side, a sense of triumphalism perhaps may not augur well for our Indian democracy. For the sake of democracy, is an out-of-court settlement not a welcome move? I would certainly say it's a welcome move. We'll simply do a short break, return with lots more on the other side.
See, central government has made it clear that it will await the judgment of the Supreme Court.
Hmm.
So central government per se in terms of its legislative authority or anything is not going to move before any judgment is made.
Hmm.
I just want to draw one fact. You know, in this case, one more argument which has been a very substantive argument which has come, that is the preamble's guarantees versus right to property.
Hmm.
You see, the preamble says that we, the people of India, will ensure justice, liberty. Now, what is liberty? Liberty of thoughts, expressions, belief, faith and worship.
Hmm.
So this has been held by the Privy Council earlier to be a superior right than right to property, because right to property is not a fundamental right.
Right.
Here claims are being made to this land on the basis of ownership of the land.
Hmm.
So even if there is an ownership of the land, faith, worship and belief is a superior right
hmm.
than this right. And hmm. that has also been argued in this case, that there exists a superior right of the Hindus of worshipping
no, that's the
place
which
where
been
they
made.
Believe
no.
Lord Ram was born.
No, but Sharad Pradhan, I mean, it's
in, now, you, in this case,
Sudhanshu Mittal may well argue, Sharad ji, he may argue that, you know, the constitution entitles him to stake claim to that property because, well, it's the Hindus have a superior right. Sharad Pradhan, can't that argument also be made by the Muslims then?
Yeah,
bigger than my rights.
Because
you know,
the
my
religious rights. You are talking about civil rights.
Go ahead, Sharad.
Well, you are absolutely right. Using the same argument, the Muslims can also come forward and the dispute goes back to square one. It doesn't make
because
any.
I don't think it
makes so much sense. So much sense.
They
that is the problem.
Worship
the
there.
Why
they have not been
the
worshipping there. There is no faith and there is no belief
insisted.
Involved there.
Let me
and a masjid, by definition, in the
speak.
Ethics of
let
Islam,
also speak.
Is
Sure. Go ahead.
Will you leave? The reason why the Chief Justice of India repeatedly talked about the right to property and treating this case as a case of right to property.
Hmm.
Not once, several times he said
that. That was the earlier Chief Justice, not this Chief Justice.
Title of this land.
Do not mislead.
That's not me.
No more
that's the Chief Justice
title
saying that.
No. Let's be clear. Sir? This case, Subramaniam Swami was
he never
was
said
lied
this.
With us.
You are not the judge on the panel.
Yes. Yeah. This case is obviously about title suit, and therefore title
so
suit
you
would
not
translate. It would let's show some civility to each other. I'm Ajay Gautam. I mean, you know, even if I have to take Mr. Mittal's argument that the Indian Constitution allows me, guarantees me the right to worship, right to pray, right to faith. Now you and Maulana Sahab are there. For every freedom that you claim for yourself, Maulana Sahab will also stay true to that freedom. No.
I want to
absolutely. That's what I'm trying to argue.
Because they don't do it.
They don't do it?
In Islam, masjid is not intrinsic to Islam. Please
understand.
In the ambit of Ismail Faruqi case, the Supreme Court.
Sir, structure
Ismail Faruqi case.
Not only is it, it was masjid.
इस्माइल फारूकी केस की जजमेंट है, पहले 5 दिसंबर 2017 से सुप्रीम कोर्ट में हेयरिंग शुरू हुई दीपक मिश्रा जी ने। पहली 5 डेट पे क्या आर्गुमेंट हुआ था कि इस केस को इस्माइल फारूकी केस की एम्बिट में ना सुना जाए, क्योंकि इस्माइल फारूकी केस में एक क्लियर हो चुका था कि द मॉस्क है, इट इज नॉट द एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ द प्रैक्टिसिंग फॉर इस्लाम, ये क्लियर हो चुका था। इसलिए उन्होंने कहा था कि आप इस्माइल फारूकी नहीं सुनेंगे। दूसरी चीज,
आप और विराग गुप्ता और विक्रमादित्य जी बैठे हैं, आप मुझको एक बात बताइए,
10 सेकंड सर, क्लियर हो जाएगी बात
की बात पे, मैं उसी क्लैरिटी पे हूं। विराग जी एक मिनट भाई, 6 दिसंबर 1992 तक वहां पे एक ढांचा था, कुछ तो था,
कुछ
मकान था, बिल्डिंग थी, इमारत थी,
मंदिर था सर, मंदिर था, पूजा हो रही थी, पूजा हो रही थी, ये मंदिर ही तोड़ दिया,
वो ढांचा जो
था पूजा हो रही थी
वो टूट गया,
इन्होंने मंदिर तोड़ दिया,
ढांचा टूट गया, उस टूटे हुए ढांचे को बाद में
सुप्रीम कोर्ट को धोखा दे करके सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने पूजा हो रही थी वहां पे, वो ढांचा क्या था
आप टाइटल सुन के बात कर रहे हैं।
मैं तो ये कह रहा हूं कि ढांचा था भाई, ढांचा था, ढांचा टूट गया,
कोर इशू समझ लीजिए ना,
टूट गया उसकी बात नहीं करेंगे,
आप टाइटल सुन की बात कर रहे
हैं,
उसकी बात नहीं करते
सर। एक बात बताइए, आफ्टर द एनफोर्समेंट ऑफ द एक्ट नंबर 33, आफ्टर द एनफोर्समेंट ऑफ द एक्ट नंबर 33 व्हिच नोन एज द अयोध्या ऑर्डिनेंस पास्ड बाय द पार्लियामेंट इन फरवरी 1993, द टाइटलशिप बिलोंग्स टू द यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया।
उपेंद्र, देयर इज अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग साइड टू इट। See, the court, while adjudicating the land title issue, has also looked at the findings of the Archaeological Survey of India, that there existed a temple below this place which was so-called a mosque. And the evidence which is there on record, which has been seen, has motives, he has everything to indicate the presence of a temple. Now, this vital evidence which is there in the court cannot be overlooked, even if it is to decide on the title suit, because a title which has been fraudulently obtained or obtained out of coercion or force cannot give them a title of ownership. So from day one, the claim of the Hindu side was there existed a temple where Ram was born, and this temple was destroyed by Babur, and because he was a conqueror, so as a part of his conquest he demolished the temple and then he built up a mosque there, which was wrong, and so the inherent right of the Hindus because of the temple which existed there,
who are you to say this was wrong?
Away just I'm because saying, a conqueror,
Mr. Mittal, but who are you now, Mr. Mittal, to say that what Babur did was right or wrong? I mean, that can be your viewpoint, but do you really believe that the court
is, that is what the Supreme Court,
but is the court now going to, is the court going to sit in judgment on that?
The court is going to go into that evidence also, na? The court is certainly going to appreciate the evidence that there existed a temple, and there is no effective challenge to that evidence which is there on record of the Archaeological Survey of India.
So Acharya ji, kya Acharya ji main kya manu,
Acharya ji to kya stands
kya hum ye mane, and then kya hum ye mane Acharya ji ki Supreme Court mein dekhiye jo Mittal ji ka jo argument hai, kya hum ye mane ki bhai court ultimately bhakti ki bhavna ko अब जुडिशियल सैंक्टिटी चाहिए, क्या ये सवाल है क्या कोर्ट के सामने? वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग डिबेट
मुस्लिम कॉज वॉज शाहबुद्दीन हैड सेड यू गिव मी वन शेड ऑफ एविडेंस दैट देयर एग्जिस्टेड अ टेंपल एंड आई विल बी द फर्स्ट वन हु ब्रेक द बाबरी मस्जिद डाउन,
दैट इज माय क्वेश्चन,
दिस इज व्हाट शाहबुद्दीन हैड सेड। नाउ टुडे
कासमी साहब डज नॉट एग्री, कासमी साहब
सर, यू आर रेफरिंग टू द ASI फाइंडिंग्स, ASI फाइंडिंग्स आर वेरी मच कंटेंशियस and questionable.
Supreme Court now will have to give judicial sanctity to question of faith. So for all the argument that this is a title suit land case, is it ultimately at the end of the day not title suit? Is it about faith, Virat?
I think that that technical judgment will be given, but I have one very strong question, strong question from Mr. Mittal. He has talked about the archaeological survey and the Sayyid Sabuddin. Narsingha Rao government has given the affidavit that if there are evidences, then they will release the land for the temple purposes. Section 6 of the
Sir Narsingha Rao has been upheld by the Supreme Court.
Why, why the government is
to restore the Babri Masjid on the same side?
No. And second, my question is that they have filed an application before the general election. Why the central government has not pressed for argument? Why in this 40 days central government has not argued?
Sharad.
Mittal and other BJP chaps have been talking about the ASI report and all. If you go into history and excavations, then keep on going backwards.
Well, gentlemen, let us wait for the 17th of November.
Keep on going into
I think if the courts, if it requires courts and if it requires the Chief Justice of India,
structure is also history.
If it requires the Chief Justice of India,
go back to history. Why not forget 25 years?
Let me thank all of you. Let me just say this very clearly that at the end of the day, if you require the Supreme Court Chief Justice now to sit in judgment on what historical right or wrong was committed some 500 years back, it also tells you maybe about the futility of what has gone on for so many years as far as the Ayodhya dispute is concerned. On the other side of this break, we'll play a special ground report.